The third addition reaction is hydration, which can be viewed as adding of water, H2O. It is used to convert alkenes into alcohols. The conditions will be 300 degrees Celsius, pressure 60 atmosphere, and the catalyst used will be phosphoric 5 acid, H3PO4. If you look at the structures, again using ethene as an example. So this is ethene. Water, H2O. So unlike the previous few examples where there are only two atoms in the molecule, we have three atoms here. But it's not really that much complicated. We will just break them into two groups. So for example, this will be one of them, and then this will be the other group. So one of them, the H, will be joined to this carbon. The OH group will be joined to the other carbon. No more double bonds, single bonds. Right, as mentioned, the H, hydrogen, joined to one of them, one carbon. The OH will be joined to the other carbon. And this will be our alcohol. It's alcohol, which is a later lesson, because it contains the hydroxyl group, functional group here, the OH. Sometimes you might not see the single bond drawn explicitly. Sometimes you might see the carbon, and then they draw the single bond OH, but it is the same. So we have ethene, addition of steam, we will get the alcohol ethanol. A quick recap, linking all the reactions. From large alkanes, we can use catalyst and heat to crack them, to break them into smaller molecules. We can get our alkenes. I'll use ethene as example. Right, of course, smaller alkanes and hydrogen might also be obtained. And from ethene, we can join to the other reactions. If we make it react with hydrogen, 200 degrees with nickel, hydrogenation, you can visualize that the H and the H will be joined to the carbons across the double bonds. I'll use a different color so we can maybe see that these are the new additions. So that's hydrogenation. Get ethane. If you add aqueous bromine, you get 1,2-dibromoethane. And the bromine brown color solution will decolorize, indicates that we have added something that contains an unsaturated organic compound. If you add steam, 300 degrees, 60 atmosphere with catalyst of phosphoric 5 acid, you'll be adding water. H will be here, and we have OH on the other carbon. You'll get ethanol. So be very familiar with a flowchart like this. Practice on your own using propene or butene as practice. Polyunsaturated and monounsaturated, I use 3 molecules for comparison. This is an organic molecule. It is saturated, okay, because we can see that all the carbon bonds are single bonds. Do not be confused by this double bond here. This double bond is between the carbon and oxygen, right? So we do not consider this as unsaturated. It is saturated because we only look at the bonds between carbon. This is unsaturated because it contains the double bond here. And if we want to be more specific, it is monounsaturated because it only contains one double bond. If you compare it to the molecule below, they are unsaturated for sure because of the double bonds. But consider, we call this polyunsaturated because it contains more than one double bond. Right? Poly means many. So that's the difference between unsaturated, the monounsaturated, and the polyunsaturated. So that's the end for the alkenes lesson. In the next lesson, we will cover the alcohols.